Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. MACMOST is brought to you by the more than 300 people that support it through its Patreon campaign. Find out how you can become a part of it at MACMOST.com/Patreon. So today let's take a look at using shapes in Pages, Keynote, and Numbers. Now I'm going to use Keynote here because it makes more sense to be playing around with shapes on a nice empty canvas like in Keynote, but you can do all the same stuff in Pages if you're making a document. So you can select a shape, and there are tons of different shapes, but you can alter these shapes. You can change the lines and points in them. You can also combine shapes, which is what I'm going to talk about today. So for instance, let's take something simple like a square, and let's add a circle as well. We have two different shapes. Now we can combine these in a variety of different ways. Right now there are two shapes. I could certainly command click and get both of those, and then I go to arrange and I could group them together. And now I can move them together as one thing. But what I'm talking about here is actually going to Format, Shapes and Lines, and using one of these options here. I can unite the shapes, find the intersection of them, subtract them, or find the exclusion of them. So uniting them simply brings them both together. So now I have one shape here. It's a single shape. It's not two shapes grouped. I can't detach them anymore. And it takes the combined form of everything in there. So let's undo there and try another one. I've got intersect shape. So that's going to take just the area where the two shapes have intersected, and it creates a new shape out of that. I can also go to subtract, and that's going to subtract the shape that's on top from the shape that's on the bottom. So it's going to cut out a piece. And the last one is to find the exclusion. So basically any place where they overlap, it's going to cut that out. And any place where they don't overlap, it's going to keep that. So those are some of the basics there. You can use these to make new shapes. So for instance, let's start with a circle. And I'll just make this a little bit bigger. And then let's say, let's go to something like under Arts, the guitar here. And you can see this guitar. I'm going to make it a different color temporarily over here in the Format sidebar just so I could see it when I put it on top. I'm going to make it larger. And I'm also going to rotate it so I can kind of stick it in the middle there. Grow it up a little bit more there. So there we go. So I've got something like this. This could be like a symbol. Now, if I wanted to make this a single shape, what I could do is I could select one and then the other. And of course, if I were to unite them, I would just have the guitar neck sticking out of the circle. But if I were to go and find the intersection, I would cut everything else out. What's more interesting is subtracting the shapes like that, so cutting out the shape of the guitar from inside the circle, or even better yet, excluding them and creating an interesting shape like this that kind of gives me a different little logo-ish look for a guitar. So now I've got this shape here. I could use that and color it in, and I could, you know, do what I want with it inside my document. I could even go ahead and save it as a custom shape. So you can see it's here. I can give it a name and continue to use it in other projects. So you can do a lot with this. One of the disadvantages of combining shapes like this is a shape is only one color. So whatever the color is, whether it's a full fill or a gradient, I could certainly use a gradient instead. And then it's technically multiple colors, right? So I could change this to another shade there. But in general, it's one basic color fill or gradient fill. So that's maybe not the best reason to combine shapes. But you certainly can use it to create some of your own shapes. You can combine certainly many more than just the two that I was showing. So, you know, I could combine a guitar, and then I could add drums, and then I could add something else like saxophone. I can have these all separate shapes here, select them all, and I could unite them. Now I have a single shape, or I could bring them closer to each other so they actually overlap or intersect each other in some way. So it does give you the ability to get a little more creative with shapes, and it certainly if you're animating or using some sort of transition in Keynote, it could be easier to have things grouped together as one shape image rather than several separate ones.